Hi guys, Patient Chimp here. Welcome to day 15 of my Minecraft Survival Guide and Let's Play. Today's episode we're going to talk about ender chests and we're going to go and defend the Acacia village we found. An ender chest is a chest that you can place in one area and access the items in another area by placing another ender chest. To build the ender chest, it's quite simple. You simply combine an ender eye with an ender pearl with a piece of blade powder to make an ender eye. You then place the ender eye in the center and surround it with obsidian. I'm going to make two, one for this end, one for the other end. I'm going to take it down to our storage area and load it up with the stuff that we're going to need. These can't be stacked double like the other ones. What we're going to need is an epic amount of cobblestone. Apart from that one, because that one's not cobblestone. Because we're going to head over to the Acacia village and try and protect it from mobs. That's gravel. That's cobblestone. I'm going to take one full stack of iron. Two full stacks of wood. Normally I take a crafting table, a furnace and a bed, but I already have one over there. Yeah, really all we need is the cobblestone. Everything else is accessible from the other end. I already have food at the other end, so I don't need to take that. Also, I know that there is a librarian there, and a librarian trades paper for emeralds, so what I'm going to do is bring my stack of sugar cane, and then turn it into paper when we get there, and take all things. I think we should take our horse today, as we've got to, make the journey a little bit quicker. I've already mostly planned the route, made a few temporary dirt bridges over some of the water, because swimming with a horse is a nightmare. Mostly plan the route, so shouldn't be too bad. We're going to keep our eye out for torches that I've placed to lead us to the way we're going. Careful not to drop too far, because the horse can get hurt. If the horse loses all his hearts on the bottom right, it will die. Whether you can rescue your saddle or not, I'm not entirely sure. Now, as we head towards the desert, we should start to see some torches. Hopefully. Trying to avoid as much of the water as possible. We're actually just heading to the banner on the map, so I probably came over at a slightly different angle. Oh, there's a torch up there. We just basically now need to follow the torches to the village. Taken one of these houses as my own, this one. So I had somewhere safe to leave my horse. Okay, now we're placed down out in the chest. As you can see, we have access to all the items that we placed in it back at our base. It's going to clear out most of my inventory and begin preparing to protect the village. Making some cobblestone wall. You can also like double stack these, and you can keep doing this until you end up with 64 in each slot. Okay, that's looking good to me. Let's go and find the edge of the village. It's going to be a bit of a zigzaggy wall by the looks of it, but we only need to keep the mobs out, so. I think we'll make a star around here. Come back and break all the misplaced blocks in a moment. the idea is to keep the villagers in and the mobs out. Okay, now we've been all the way around, we can begin to place our cobblestone wall. Doing our best to protect the villagers. While we're doing it. Is that a villager or a husk sneaking around that corner? It's a villager. The villager should be hiding in the house. You can do this with wooden fence if you want, but I thought as we had so much cobblestone, you might as well do it with that. Thank you. Can't hit a spider. More creepers. Okay, a few minor repairs. See that gap there, they could sneak in through. You can see why I'm protecting this village, can't you? It's a bit overrun with mobs. Being careful, because we did pass a ravine along the edge of our wall. Hopefully, we brought enough stuff. Looks like it. Ah, yeah. You know what I said about be careful? That was why. Next thing I'll show you why. Mouse will work, so let's just press number one. That's why.
Because you can keep any bitch. I got my rich tea. I'll tell you how much junkie, a funky.
Sorry, my new ringtone. It's lovely crunchy biscuits from the TV series 2 points of lager and a packet of crisps. Is we go around and put some gates in it in a little while, but first of all we're gonna need some more torches. Which one did I steal from my house? It's the one with the stable out the back. That one, there we go. Charcoal's pretty easy to make, just stick something in the bottom. Yeah, then that should make me 12 charcoal. Just in case I haven't got enough torches. Tricky. Okay. Okay. Now we'll make some wooden fences. And then we'll start scattering light all about the place. I don't know if you get more light from the higher you put them or not. At this point in the game, we shouldn't be short of any resources, so... try that for now. Place. What we do is we spend a couple of nights in the village, see where the mobs spawn, and make sure we've lit the area up enough. Because we don't want these villagers to die, because we need them. Better eat in a minute. I've noticed that my hunger bar is quite low. not too bad. That's the first mod we've seen. Okay then, more torches. Outside the wall there. A zombie or a creeper? A creeper. Again, outside the wall. Dark spot there. Dark spot there. Thank you.
here.
Be careful not to let him knock us down there. We'll do something about that in a little while. Some more fences. Oh, what? They didn't just walk straight in there. I'm lighting up outside the bloody wall. I am, aren't I? Say that was pretty well lit up then. So I'm happy with that, we'll just have to wait and see. make a quick bit of paper and see if we can find the librarian. That's about it for the use of Ender Chest and Village Defense. Got to wind around and look for a guy in a white jumper. Not that one. That's a nice house. Where's that one? Ah, there he is. Hello. Yeah, this guy chose 34 paper for one emerald. We got his upgrading. Let's see what he does next. Compass for one emerald. Go and grab some more paper. Is that the one? Yes. Looks like we're going to have to trade him a compass to get him to upgrade. Tidy some of this up a bit as well off the camera, make it a bit more easy to navigate. Oh, I can't, I haven't got any redstone. Off the camera, I'm going to make a few trips back and forth and get rid of the stuff that we don't need. And then I'd like to go down in the next episode and tackle that ravine. See what we can find. Probably not worth me digging down to find some redstone. We've got plenty of trades going on here. Coal. Coal again. Zombie flesh. Paper. Let's put a few doors on around here and there. More paper. By the looks of it, I think they're going to be pretty safe. We could dig down really quickly and see if we could find some redstone. I'll find some redstone off camera. I've got to go down a ravine anyway. I might change the block colour on my house as well, so I know which one it is. Okay guys, thanks for watching. If you found anything interesting or enjoyed this episode, please leave a like, maybe even consider subscribing. See you in the next episode.